A lot of things were going on all at the same time, and it's a little dizzying. And, you know, the Joshua Tree was a very big record. I think it changed us. And we sort of went into the Rattle and Hum experience and did that and did the movie and got a little burnt by that experience. And I think we're feeling like we'd sort of reached the end of an era for U2, and we had to do something. So, I mean, it wasn't totally conscious. It was like we all felt the same way. And when we went in to record Octoon Baby, we went in with a slightly different spirit in which we'd gone in to make our previous records. And we sort of said, look, if we can't pull this together, and if this is not going to work, if this album is not going to happen, if we're not happy with the songs, whatever, maybe it's time to call it quits. And we were very serious about that. And as it happened, it sort of kick-started the second half of the game, so to speak. And, but
why Berlin? I can't really remember back that far.
Going into this record, we knew that certain things we'd done we didn't want to do again, certain kinds of songs we didn't want to write again. The whole process in Berlin and in Dublin was finding out exactly where we did want to go.
Oh, I can't even say the bloody word. Octoon Baby.
It's a calm. It's a calm. And it's just a way of putting people off from the fact that it's a heavy mother. It's probably our most serious record, and yet it's the least serious title.
Welcome to Zoo TV.
Thank you for joining us live on the air.
My pleasure.
Zoo TV thing is pushing it as far as we can. I
want to take a look at what we got for Christmas here. We got a TV station.
Hey, New York.
We're into Zoo TV. You know, that's where we're at. I'm into it, we're into it, and I really think that the real U2 fans that have been around, they'll be into it. All the things I despised about rock and roll, I've now surrounded myself with. And I'm really enjoying it.
I think all the shows have been pretty much sold out. The audience seems to have a good feel for what's going on out there, and yeah, we're having a good time.
Yeah, I've had a good time the last week.
When we arrive, it's all up, you know.
I'd love to stay behind and just see it all come down and go up one day, but so far I haven't actually been able to do that.
In this circus, everybody's got their own sort of job. They're the strong men, right? And, you know, in the sort of trapeze act, there's the wires there for the trapeze. I'm a sword swallower myself.
Let's go to Bono on stage.
Him up. I think he's been around for a long time. I just think Bono likes to wear his clothes.
Gives Bono a chance to do things and say things that he himself would never do or say.
McFisto's like a sad, bad finale. He's like the last pop star, I don't know. He's all kinds of things, all mixed up.
Look what you've done to me. You made me very famous, and I thank you. I know you like your pop stars to be exciting, so I bought these.
And he's getting tired and he's kind of fed up. See, I'm talking in the third person, like those actors. When you see them interviewed, they always say, well, my character, she's the kind of person, or he's not. I never thought I'd do that. I just did that there. You know, that's a first. I better quit this now.
Frank Sinatra, I give you MTV.
But why should I try to resist when, baby, I know so well that I've got you under my skin.
Salman Rushdie, I give you decibels.
Real devils don't wear horns.
Salman Rushdie, ladies and gentlemen, I bow to the superior man.
I don't know what the next step is, and that's what's great about being in U2. I never know what's coming next. You know, you just gotta keep yourself interested, because as long as you're interested, you know, somebody else is gonna be.